So it's a very important and interesting thing in digital systems. So you just keenly watch. We are normally using a decimal system. So I'm having two numbers, 56 and 32. So I want to subtract these two numbers. So we know if these numbers are in the base 10, then our answer will be 24. So this subtraction we can easily do. And these complements are used in digital system to reduce the complexity of the calculations. So what was the use of complement is, in all the digital devices, the subtraction is converted to addition. So how it is this possible? Using complements. So there will be, for any base, there will be two type of complements. One is radix complement. Another one is diminished radix. So what are they? So if I am following a decimal system, the base 10, then diminished radix is a 9th complement. Radix system is 10th complement. So for decimal system, we'll be using 10th complement and 9th complement. 10th complement is called as radix. The another name for base is radix. So base 10 can be also mentioned as radix 10. So if I am having a binary, so in the binary, the system is 2. So radix system is will be 2's complement. Diminished radix will be 1's complement. So there are some formula to calculate this one. So I am just writing the formula for the calculation of diminished radix. So diminished radix can be determined by an equation. Radix power n minus 1 minus n, where n is the number whose complement is to be determined. So n is the number whose complement is to be obtained. And radix is, if you add 1 to diminished radix, it becomes radix complement. So r power minus 1. So you need not confuse with this. If I substitute of r is equal to 10 in the first equation, so I am going to obtain the 9th complement and 10th complement. So the 9th complement, the formula will be r power n minus 1. So if I am interested to find the complement for 32, suppose I am having a decimal number 32, I want to determine the 9th complement of this 32. How I need to do is, I have to use this particular formula. So 9th complement formula is, so here the digit is 2 digit number I need to convert. So n, small n is equal to 2. So the formula to be used is, radix is 10 power 2 minus 1 minus 32. So r power 2, 10 power 2 is 100, 100 minus 1, 99 minus 32. So this will be the 9th complement. So the 9th complement is 67. So 9th complement of 32 is 67. So what about 10th complement? Then the 10th complement will be 9th complement plus 1. So it will be 68. So this is how you can determine the 9th and 10th complement of this number. And why we need such a number? We are very comfortable in using 32. Why I need some changes in 32? So let us see this subtraction problem. While doing in computer, we can use complement to convert it into a addition problem. So complements are used to convert the subtraction to addition. Let me say the thing here. To find the 9th complement, you need not remember this. If you feel this formula is tough to remember, the simple thing is, if you want to find 9th complement, subtract every digit by 9. So 99 minus 32. So the answer is 67. This is 9th complement. 10th complement is just add 1 to it. Now what I am going to do is, I am having 56. And here I am having So this is original number. This is 2's complement, sorry, 10's complement of 32. Now I am going to convert the subtraction to addition. So only thing is, this minus 32 is converted to its 10's complement form. Now have addition. 6 plus 8 is 14. So that will be carry. So here 124. So answer is 124. This one is extra carry. So this extra carry, if it is omitted, what is the answer you are getting is 24, which is the exact equal of your subtraction. So for any subtraction, here a computer will do like this. What it will do is, it will take minus 32. So to represent minus 32, it will be using the 10's complement form, and then it is doing. So whatever we are discussing in decimal, the computer will do it in binary. So for example, here, another interesting fact is that, what is it is, if I try to subtract bigger number from smaller number, so the same subtraction, now I want to perform 32 minus 56. So my answer will be minus 24. How it is represented in a computer? The computer will treat the second number, that is your subtrahend, will be converted into a complement form. So what is the 9's complement of 56? So 9's complement of 56 is very easy. Just subtract each and every digit from 9. So you'll be getting 43. So what about the 10's complement? So 10's complement of 56 is 44. Just 9 complement number plus 1. Now what the computer will do is, it will convert this subtraction to addition. So 32 plus 10's complement of 56, that is 44. Now it will perform the addition, 6, 7. So 76 is the answer. So what is 76? 32 minus 56 is minus 24, that we know. But what we are going to do with this 72? Why the answer is represented like this? So if there is no carry, so here in the previous case we generate a carry, here no carry. So no carry indicates, no carry in the final addition indicates, you are trying to subtract A minus B and B is greater than A. So when you are attempting to do the subtraction A minus B, and if B is greater than A, then you are trying to subtract a larger number from a smaller number. So the answer is negative. So if this is, so no carry indicates that one. So what about this answer? If it is a negative answer, it will store the result in 10's complement form again. So if 76 is a 10's complement form of some answer, you find the actual answer. So 9's complement of this 76 is, subtract each digit from 9. So you'll be getting 23. 10's complement is 23 plus 1, 24. So this is the actual answer. As the answer is negative, it is stored as a 2's complement form. So what we need to understand is, if computer is doing some calculations in binary, it is going to use its complement form and convert the subtraction to addition. So that's the first thing. If it is performing that addition, in some addition, carry may be generated. In some addition, carry may not be generated. So what's the thing is, if carry is generated, it is attempting some A minus B, where A is greater than B. So the answer is exactly a positive number. So you are getting the answer directly. If I do the subtraction A minus B, where B is greater than A, again, the negative number is converted to 10's complement and added. You are getting some answers without carry, which indicates the answer is negative. So the negative answer is stored as a 10's complement. To find the original answer, you need to take the 10's complement of this number to get 24. So these are the things you need to remember while using the complement. For our easier understanding, I have started with the decimal conversion, the decimal based. But inside the computer, you will be going to have only binary system. So whatever we are discussing, we will be going to use 2's complement and 1's complement. Suppose I want to perform 4 minus 3 in a computer. So the answer is 1 base 10. So how it is being performed in a computer? It will convert everything into binary. So what we will be doing is 4 is converted to 100. The equivalent of 3 is 11. So to have an equal digit, I am putting an extra 0 here. So this is 3. I want to subtract this one. So for that, what the computer will do is, it will take the 2's complement of this 3. So what is 1's complement? So 1's complement of this number is, subtract each and every digit with 1. In 10's complement, 9's complement, what we'll be doing, we'll be subtracting all the digits from 9. Here for 1's complement, you subtract all the digits with 1. It is just equal to changing the digits. So 0 will be changed to 1, 1 will be changed to 0. If you subtract this number from 111, you are going to get the same answer. 001. So this is the 1's complement. So 1's complement is very simple. You just invert the digits. 011 is converted to 100. So now I am going to take the 2's complement. So 2's complement is just addition of 1 to a 1's complement. So you are getting 101. Now I want to perform this subtraction. So to perform this subtraction, I am taking the first number is a positive, so as it is. Second number is minus 3, you need to go for the 2's complement. Now I am placing 101. Now I have converted this subtraction to addition by considering the 2's complement of 3. So this is the original number 4, this is the 2's complement of 3. So now I am doing an addition. So 1 plus 1, 2, again it is converted to binary as 10. So this is the answer. So it generates a carry which indicates A is greater than B. So the answer is positive. So 001, that is 1 is the answer. So this is how any subtraction is performed using the complements. And here if you see, the solution will be same. So this is equivalent to 1. So complements are very much useful in computers.